In this video, we are going to talk about the Cisco stock. So before starting this video, please like this video and subscribe to this channel for our future updates. Cisco Systems, CSCO, shares touched a 22-month high on June 11th as the market continues to favor value equities linked to an economic recovery. The stock's future hinges on trends in cloud computing infrastructure, as well as business and telecom networks. Cisco's adjusted earnings and revenue for the third quarter of fiscal year 2021 above analyst expectations. In a recent report to clients, Oppenheimer analyst Ittai Kidron wrote, "The company is seeing a better demand backdrop as customers resume postponed projects and pull forward planned projects. As a result of the decreasing COVID-19 headwinds, order patterns improved dramatically across every area and client category. However, supply chain restrictions continue to weigh on profits, and headwinds are projected to last until the end of the year. Corporate spending on data networks had slowed due to higher office vacancy rates during the coronavirus outbreak. According to one viewpoint, as remote work grows more common, corporate networks will become less necessary. As a result, Cisco stock will have to increase its spending in next-generation enterprise networks. Cisco wants to assist businesses in creating hybrid network designs that combine on-premise data centers with cloud computing infrastructure. In order to compete with Microsoft, MSFT, and Zoom Video Communications, Cisco wants to expand its WebEx video conferencing platform, ZM. Cisco emphasized hybridization as a foundation block to its product strategy. At its Cisco Live virtual conference in late March, Morgan Stanley analyst Meta Marshall said in a note to clients, "Cisco's ability to gain market share in cloud computing data centers is a major question. Cisco's major competitor in that area is Arista Networks, ANET. Is a transformational acquisition of Cisco stock required? Some CSCO stock bulls feel the company requires a large, transformational acquisition. Scott Herren, formerly of Autodesk, has joined Cisco as its new Chief Financial Officer, ADSK. Cisco stock is still one of the most cash-rich tech businesses in the United States. CSCO stock is still popular among institutional investors, thanks to its 4% dividend yield. While Cisco stock pays a generous dividend, the company's share repurchase program has stalled. Technical analysis of the CSCO stock. From a 1990 initial public offering through early 2000, Cisco thrived as a major supplier of the hardware to build internet networks, both to telecom firms and large companies outside that sector. Before the dot-com boom burst, Cisco stock rose by more than 100,000%. Cisco revenue remained constant or decreased from the first quarter of 2016 to the end of 2017. Beginning in early 2018, revenue began to climb again, albeit in the low single digits. The inflection triggered a rise in Cisco stock. Cisco stock hit new highs in 2019 after breaking out in October 2017, a period that coincided with the dot-com boom in the late 2000s. The Trump administration's tax cuts contributed significantly to Cisco's earnings increase in 2018. Acquisitions have accounted for a large portion of Cisco's revenue growth. Cisco agreed to pay $730 million for IMI Mobile, a cloud communication software company based in the United Kingdom. Cisco paid $1 billion for ThousandEyes, a networking intelligence business, in May 2020. Cisco paid $3.7 billion for AppDynamics, a software company. In late 2017, it paid $1.9 billion for BroadSoft. Cisco purchased Duo Security for $2.35 billion in July 2019, marking the company's largest cybersecurity acquisition since acquiring SourceFire in 2013. Cisco increased its position in the developing category of Zero Trust cybersecurity by acquiring Duo Security. Aside from acquisitions, revenue recognition has benefited from new accounting standards. Shift to recurring revenue in CSCO stock. Companies may spend less on internal computer networks as they shift their workloads to cloud computing services like Amazon Web Services, which is part of Amazon.com, AMZN. Cisco has also lost market share in a number of important areas, while it hopes to regain ground in cybersecurity. Companies have cut back on information technology spending in the wake of the coronavirus outbreak. Cisco's earnings increased 5% year-over-year to 83 cents a share in the first quarter of this year, according to the company. Revenue increased 7% year-over-year to $12.8 billion, thanks to the acquisition of Acacia Communications. Cisco earned 79 cents per share on sales of $12 billion a year ago. Cisco was anticipated to earn 82 cents per share on sales of $12.57 billion, according to analysts. Cisco forecasted earnings of 82 cents per share for the current quarter, falling short of analyst expectations of 85 cents. Cisco, on the other hand, forecasted sales growth of 7%, which was higher than analyst expectations of 5.7%. During the last quarter, the company repurchased $510 million of its own stock, compared to $801 million in the previous quarter. Sales of Catalyst 9000 computer network switches have been a bright spot for CSCO shares. Cisco also has an opportunity in data center renovations. The so-called Internet Cloud is built up of data centers the size of warehouses. Racks of computer servers, data storage systems, and networking equipment are crammed into them. The majority of cloud computing data centers today have communications equipment capable of 100 gigabits per second. The upgrade of data centers to 400G technology has been postponed. In the 400G upgrade cycle, the main question is whether Arista or Cisco will gain market share. Is there a future for Cisco stock in data centers? Cisco agreed to pay $2.6 billion in cash for Acacia Communications, a manufacturer of 400G equipment, in 2019. The purchase has been postponed by China's authorities. Cisco increased their bid for Acacia to $4.5 billion in January, and the sale was finally completed in February. Arista beat Cisco to market in cloud data centers, securing customers like as Microsoft, Facebook, FB, and Amazon.com, AMZN. Cisco, on the other hand, is said to have gained business from Microsoft. Cisco is also well-positioned, according to analysts, as corporate purchasers migrate to networking technology known as Software-Defined Wide Area Networking, or SD-WAN. The technology frequently uses public internet bandwidth. Companies no longer need to lease expensive private data networks from telecom companies thanks to SD-WAN. In the SDN market, Cisco competes with VMware, VMW, startup Ariaka, Fortinet, FTNT, and CloudGenix. CloudGenix was recently purchased by Palo Alto Networks, PANW. According to MarketSmith study, CSCO stock has an accumulation distribution rating of C-. The rating is based on a stock's price and volume fluctuations over the previous 13 weeks of trading. Cisco stock recovered after a market shift to value equities that began in late 2020. Cisco Software. Meanwhile, Cisco has a hand in almost every fast-growing software market. Cisco's WebEx conferencing software and security capabilities work together to beat out competitors like Zoom Video for enterprise contracts, NASDAQ, ZM. Its annual software revenue can reach $14 billion. Subscriptions currently account for 81% of that total, so the quarter's $3.8 billion handle is a floor, not a ceiling. Cisco is well positioned to make significant strides in the machine internet, point-of-sale software, and video content analysis, all of which are rapidly expanding markets. Software is becoming a cash cow, with an annual operating cash flow of $15 billion. This makes the yearly dividend of $1.48 per share, which costs $6.3 billion to service, quite safe. It also implies Cisco can continue to make acquisitions in order to keep its products cutting edge. Is CSCO stock a good buy right now? Cisco stock formed a flat foundation in March, with a 49.44 entry point. New goods revealed at the virtual Cisco Live conference in late March boosted the stock. CSCO shares originally dropped as a result of the company's fiscal third quarter earnings and expectations. However, shares clawed their way back. Cisco shares had risen 18% in 2021 as of June 28. However, the stock has fallen from a 22-month high of 55.45 reached on June 11. Despite the decline, CSCO stock was still trading over a buy zone of 5%. On April 20, Deutsche Bank analyst Matthew Nickum began coverage with a hold rating. Cisco screens attractively from numerous viewpoints, he wrote in a study, including a resurgence in IT investment driving favorable revenue inflections, an underlying mix shift toward software, services, and solid profitability FCF generation. However, we see no upside to consensus projections that would warrant a more optimistic outlook, and valuation is presently at a premium on a standalone and market relative basis, says the analyst. What do you think about our video? Let us know in the comments below. If you enjoy this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications before you go. Thanks for watching.